Hey gang, that's a cookie here. So, little preamble, next two videos, this room will be the last time you see this room. I mean, because this fucking light situation is getting fucking worse every time I record a video. So, without further ado, let's start the show. So, this episode's a little interesting. So, this episode is based off of the rumor myth thing about Robert Johnson. Which legend has it, he sold his soul to the devil. So, pretty fitting for this month, actually. This episode starts off in Chicago, Illinois, which means Doug Walker could probably be in the background at any point. That's scary. A woman exits from her car and enters a semi-abandoned building? Can I say squatter's rights? Anyways. With some interesting decor, really, really interesting decor, this woman breaks into a fucking wall and steals a bag. What appears to have the fucking Bible in it, by the way? But, like, this Bible isn't just a fucking holy Bible. It has a record in it somehow. Which is weird because, like, records are usually, well. So, I don't like that. I don't like the scene because mainly because it's Bible shit. Not because the Bible's there, but because that Bible's really tiny. So unless that record's really fucking tiny, which I don't think it is, the problem, because this is the Resident Evil vinyl. It's really fucking extra thick. But cut in half, still a little too big to be a Bible bookmark. So unless that tiny fucking record, I don't think the Bible is in that record. Or vice versa, for that matter. Unless, again, it's an extra thick Bible. Anyways, it cuts to the woman entering what appears to be a record label or a radio station. She then provides this to the man working in the station. He'll be important a little later. While I believe he's transcoding the audio from vinyl to what appears to be an MP3 file, after playing the record, it sends him to a suicidal state, and he unfortunately commits suicide. The reason for that being will be important a bit later. It then cuts to Z being harassed by John's homeboy from episode 2, but Z reveals she had a new vision, and he reluctantly lets her in. It then cuts to John doing what according to IMDb is an exorcism. That or he's as sexy as Zatanna.
Of devourers, swing me, la corin, la corre, locally. He who guardeth the eternal gateway, who not there yet on Bola Dachba, are seeking audience with one in your embrace.
John's homie gives Z the house tour of the House of Mystery, but it ends really early when John stops them before they get too deep into it. It then cuts to John explaining who the person who killed himself was and how he knows him, and not so subtle nod to John's punk days again. John then has Z use her powers to scry some more information out of her. And as the boys prepare to leave for Chicago, Z strong arms herself into the episode, and John crumbles into it. A bit of an important thing later, not really. Back in Chicago, John details to Z the items he has for his Nora-esque adventure.
Holy water, police scanner, cemetery dirt, duct tape.
What's this?
Oh, up! Don't touch. These are nails from the coffin of St. Padua, patron of lost souls. Watch. The nails follow one another. Took one of these in a bloke's pocket, you got yourself a nifty tracking device.
But this leads to the question now. How do they get into this building? Well, it's quite simple, really. Z then gets up to her old tricks and picks someone's wallet with a keycard in it. What is this, Resident Evil? Our heroes, everyone, I stand them, because they're just dumb dorks who are also robbing this building, apparently. While inside, John finds the body of his dear dead friend. We get another unsubtle callback to John's punk days, as John details exactly how he knew this man. John also takes something out of his pocket, and it's called
Reunited for One Final Comeback Tour, courtesy of this Hand of Glory. You take the left hand of a man that's been hanged, pickle it in amniotic fluid for 7 years, say the right incantation, and the dead will rise for as long as the candles burn.
You know, sometimes I think the magic in these shows is complete utter bullshit. Just to be spooky, you know? But, like, apparently this is a legit custom to do in Europe. I don't know if it actually works clearly, but... But wait, hold up. If you need a left hand to be glory, is the right one just for masturbation? I don't understand. The bodies around John start to compulse and scream as the body of the dead friend starts to resurrect itself with a short spell. Well, we get a vague clue, but it's the first clue in where to go next. We can see the pain in John's eyes as his friend returns to life right there, and then dies right in front of him. We see that pain a little more clear as John closes his friend's eyes one last time. Honestly, it's fucking heartbreaking. Look, I know in the past I fanboyed a lot about Matt Ryan, but just hear me out, please. He's just a good fucking actor, I swear to God, he's just a fucking good actor, just look at the way in his eyes, you can see the pain.
Rest in peace, mate.
I'm not sorry, by the way. I will never be sorry for fanboying over Matt Ryan. While mourning, John mumbles something about the moon rise and wonders what it is, and Z, being the good companion she is, but it's access out of context shit, looks into Moonrise on her smartphone. We cut to what appears to be a woman as she is being confronted. Hey gang, Nexa Giga here from the future past. This is actually the woman from the beginning of the episode. I'm dumb and didn't realize that. I should notice about the Karen haircut too, right? My bad. Her daughter, who points out that the record is causing the bookshelf to rot? Freeze? I'm not sure what this is right now. It'll say it later, I'm sure, but I think it's rotting? It's weird. Maybe ice rot? Is that a thing? Probably not. John literally uses a page of psychic paper to trick a nurse. He's literally a Time Lord now, for real this time. We get a bit of a backstory about the prior owner of the record. And what exactly causes the record to be so evil and spooky? It's the devil.
Shadows are gonna rise.
It turns out the acetate he was working on recorded something when he died.
Bits don't.
The voice of the deceiver.
That's an urban legend, mate.
This is real.
Hello? No.
It's not my time! You promised!
We actually get some really good effects, however, they use for the blues musician to fucking die sadly. As the old man and Constantine continue to argue, the old man unfortunately passes to the afterlife, as our angel returns once again to be a bit of a dick. And the gang race off to the second clue. We get some more lore dumped onto us as Constantine and Z discuss Satan. Someone! So, his show gets to have 3 seasons, but Constantine gets cancelled. Why? So, let me get this straight here. In this episode, we have literally the devil convincing a child to listen to blues and rock and roll, and it's evil. Did my grandma write this episode? Constantine breaks into a fucking mansion and tries to interrogate the person living there. His name is Ian, but his wife comes to save him and reveals that she's the one who sold her soul and why.
Ian was dying. He had cancer.
I didn't see that one coming.
You sacrificed your soul for his life.
And you show him the contract, love.
Ouch. Fuck. That hurts. Shit. Constantine goes out of his way to give Ian's wife a hug. Instead of the hug, he places one of those nails from earlier in her pocket. But it cuts to Ian's daughter listening to the record and its cursedness, clearly possessed by some kind of demon to do it. This is important later, kind of. But the eye effects don't happen ever again, by the way. It then cuts to Constantine interrogating the soul broker that was mentioned earlier off camera, as they reveal the real puppet master is Papa Shango. Nah, I'm just kidding. It's DC reoccurring villain Papa Midnight. It then cuts to Constantine and Papa Shango arguing for a bit, but then one of Papa Shango's men just pistol whips the shit at Constantine, knocking him out. Papa Midnight cruelly and violently tortures Constantine and injects him with a poison, but also leaves him behind the antidote as a form of irony, knowing that he cannot get it. While this is all happening, Papa Shango's men go ahead and rob Ian's house off the record. Look, I know this is based off his musician, but I thought it was Robert Johnson, not John Lennon, because where the fuck is his guards at? While being bound and poisoned, John is then harassed by the angel again.
Does it really surprise you that I want something a little bit more potent in my arsenal?
You're not dealing with some second-rate hellspawn. If that voice belongs to the first of the fallen, there is only one true way to deal with that record. Do you have the courage?
Maybe you'll find out once you free me from these bloody ties!
You don't need me for that. You got this situation under control.
And there it is. The revelation that we already knew, that the voice on the record was the voice of Satan himself, here to claim the fallen souls of the damned. But we already knew about that, so this is kind of a waste of revelation. Taking the angel at his advice, Constantine, bound, bleeding out, but still not dying yet, Constantine uses his psychic playing card to try to trick a homeless man. To no avail.
He's just coming out.
That's it. Cut me loose.
If you're alive, you can't use the card.
The homeless man, somehow understanding this still won't actually work for him being alive, tries to kill Constantine, but is saved by fucking Z.
No, you don't want to.
Come on! God! Get the hell out of here!
After being saved by Z, Constantine chugs the vitamin K. Oh, side note, by the way. For those who don't know, actually know what's going on here, the cure he actually needs isn't vitamin K. Vitamin K is good for warfarin. What he needs is protamine. Protamine is what he needs. The next day, Constantine and his friends go to a nightclub, but it's too late. John's homie returns and provides him some items he needs while they gossip about Z behind her back. Getting out the items that he got from his friend earlier, John pulls out his headset. John utilizes his headset to play the only good Sex Pistols song to drown out the voice of the Fallen. With no options left to do and no time to spare, John gets to work to go ahead and get to the record in time. To no avail. John goes ahead and gets the record. The others crash their car into the tower's generator, stopping it from broadcasting it to everywhere else in the area. But it's almost too late. John's headset isn't working. However, fucking Papa Midnight comes to save the day, wielding a fucking Winchester.
It's a Winchester.
Not those ones, silly. Maybe. While having a bit of a snark contest, Papa Midnight goes ahead and goes to get the record. While having a Mexican standoff, however, Constantine casts a spell to send the record and the minions to hell, leaving a bloody molten hole behind. And it ends the way every good episode ends. Constantine forces the soul broker to eat the fucking contract he gave with Ian's wife, and everyone lives happily ever after. Honestly, this fucking episode is the dopest shit ever, and here's why. So, all the pros of this episode, we have Z being badass, Z being helpful, Z getting more screen time just in fucking general. Papa Midnight's fucking badass. We also get fucking more spookiness in it, with a mixture of action. And it doesn't hinder either or. It's fucking perfect. Cons, I didn't like Sex Pistols being in here. No more Sex Pistols. Mainly because Sex Pistols suck. Thanks for hanging out with me guys. Nice to giga. I'll see you guys next time. Happy Halloween and all that. Peace.